Hey guys, it's Kevin. We're going to review this soldering machine from Yihua 948. We bought from AliExpress. Actually, it's a lot more expensive. So if I get that from Amazon, it's like a $10, $15 cheaper, and we can get it faster, and the returns easier. We were sold on this video for the Yihua knife remove through-hole components. And you can check out. And it's done. Oh, that's amazing. Actually, if you see the video carefully, it has some problem at the third hole and the fourth hole. It took him a lot longer to do it. However, you know the toys. Whenever you see it, you don't see those until you have it. So we give to Abby to do an honest review on this.
We ended up buying a new desolder machine about a week ago, and I got around to trying it out and using it. All the other desolder machines I had been using had just kind of fizzed out on me. I didn't want to use them anymore. I didn't feel they were doing the job that I needed them to do. So we ordered this one. We watched a video advertisement on it, and it looked really awesome. It looked like the ultimate of ultimate desolder machines. It was a quick poof, and it took that leg off. So I'm putting it together and I'll show you a bit about it. I like that you could grab it and take it to another room and I dropped it, so maybe I should not be taking it from room to room. It has a three-prong power cord to it. Then this was the actual desolder gun part. It looked very pretty and I liked that you could see the inside. So this one actually also came with a bunch of accessories for replacements, filters, and cleaning tools. So you could clean this out every now and again. And that little light on the side was supposed to tell you when it was getting too dirty and when to clean it. So there's these two tubes on there. One is to the actual gun. Well, they're both to the actual gun. But one is for that vacuum, and then one is to plug that desolder gun in there. The cool thing, too, was we didn't get it that had the desolder and the solder, but I have my own soldering machine. So you could unplug that and put back and forth whatever you want to be using at the time. When I actually got around to turning this on, that's when I was able to calibrate, program to whatever I wanted. I found it to be interesting because they had two options, a power off mode, like if you leave it too long, and then a sleep mode, which it made me laugh on the screen when it went to sleep. It put SLP on the screen and it told me that if I want to wake it back up, I pick it up and I shake it a little. I thought that was funny. Here's the part when I am testing out the gun. I was disappointed because it was not what it showed in the advertisements. In the advertisement, it made it look as if this was the ultimate of ultimates, where you put it on there, squeeze the trigger, and it goes poof, and it takes that leg off basically instantaneously. When I was doing it, it took a little bit for it to even start to melt on the leg. I had this set according to the correct temperatures. I even put it up a little bit higher than what it says it should be, but I didn't want to burn my board. I'll let you listen to what the sound it actually made. It made more of a buzzing, like a bzzz, while I held it, whereas in the video I made more like a boop kind of sound. So I'll let you listen to that. So I obviously did hold the trigger down a little bit longer, but that's because I realized after a while of using this, it wasn't going to just be a as you can see, I did get one of the legs on there pretty clean, but I did have to keep going back to my solder machine at my desk, my sit-down desk, to finally actually get all those transistors off the board. Here's one of those kind of basic solder guns just to see if it works better. And no, it doesn't. I don't like those. I usually am not smart enough to remember to actually push down that plunger part. Let me introduce you now to desolder machine called Jesus, because it died on me a year ago and I was terribly, terribly sad. It's my favorite. It works the best for me. I was about to throw it away this morning. I decided to plug it in one last time to see if it worked, and it resurrected this morning. So thank goodness for desolder machine Jesus. You can see that took me about one try, and I was able to clean that pin. So, all right, that's the smaller machines.
Also want to point out, if you want to return on AliExpress, I think the forks means yes, and the no should be spoon. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video, and do not buy this piece of shit. Please visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.